हेलो नमस्कार एंड आदाब टू ऑल माय फ्रेंड्स फ्रॉम योर फ्रेंड एस्ट्रोलॉजर एंड गाइड इरफान वंस मोर विथ यू फ्रॉम योर वेरी ओन चैनल एस्ट्रो एश्योरेंस। इन मेकिंग वीडियोस फॉर वेरियस एसेंडेंट्स वन ऑफ द रिक्वेस्ट विच केम टू मी एंड वाज कमिंग सिंस अ फ्यू मंथ्स वाज टू मेक अ वीडियो ऑन द डिफरेंट एसेंडेंट्स ऑफ द नवमांश चार्ट, विच मीन्स दैट इफ यू आर बॉर्न इन अ सर्टन एसेंडेंट इन द नवमांश चार्ट व्हाट डज इट मीन, what are the manifestations, what are the probabilities and what are the challenges or issues or situations you may face. Now while I am making this long video where I am taking through all the ascendants, there are certain things which are important for us to remember, and this is not only based on the construct of the zodiac and how the zodiac determines which navamsa goes into which sign and so forth out of the 108 navamsas, but also that in certain signs when you're born in a certain ascendant in your D1 chart, in your lagna chart, you may not go or you may not come out in a certain navmansh, which means that for example if you're born in the Aries sign then you will never have the ascendants of Capricorn, Aquarius or Pisces. Similarly with Leo sign as well, if you're born in the Leo ascendant in your D1 chart then you will not be born or you will not have the navmansh of Capricorn, Aquarius or Pisces. And same thing for Sagittarius ascendants as well, that you may not be born in the Capricorn, Aquarius or Pisces navmansh if your D1 has either Aries, Leo or Sagittarius signs. So there are certain deeper meanings of that, deeper manifestation of these also. And I have also made a video about what are the four main energies which control or guide you based on what your navmansh comes out. So your navmansh tells us that at a microscopic level, at the DNA level, what are the four main energies which are controlling or guiding or deciding various facets of our life, various situations of our lives, various results of our lives as well. So please look at that video also, please go through that video. I wanted to release that video first before I made this video about the 12 ascendants of the navmansh, so that if you have seen that video first and then you see this, then you will be able to understand the being born different ascendants in the navmansh better. So let's jump directly into our topic for today. Let's start with the Aries ascendant of the navmansh first. Now if you are born in the Aries ascendant, what does this mean? It means that in your D1 chart, in your lagna chart, you will definitely not have been born in the Cancer, Scorpio or Pisces ascendant. If you are born in any of these Cancer, Scorpio or Pisces ascendant, in any of these water signs, then you will not have a Aries navmansh. So this is an important thing. Now what does that mean? It means that your lagna, your main lagna energies will not be controlled by Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces energies. Most of your energies will be related to the other types, maybe to fire or to air or to the earth signs. You may be able to demonstrate more of in your life, in your navmansh as a basic energy. However, not so much of Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces in different facets of your life. The other is that, as I've said before in my earlier video, the Kendras of the navmansh chart show which are the four main energies which are controlling your life. So for an Aries ascendant native, the controlling energies of your horoscope are Aries, Cancer, Libra and Capricorn. And these are the energies which not only control your four Kendras, but your entire life. And I have also said that the trines from each of these houses are also controlled by the same energies and not what is seen in the horoscope. So for example, the trine for an Aries ascendant native of the navmansh chart shows Leo energies in the 5th house and Sagittarius energies in the 9th house. However, the main energies which are controlling even these areas of life, these houses, are also that of overarching Aries energies. What does this mean? This means that while you as a person have the Aries energies, whatever ascendant you may be born in the D1 chart, you will be a person who is a fighter, who will know to stand up for yourself, who will think actively. You have a very dynamic personality, and you also are somebody who is very highly motivated and have a very high willpower. At the same time, in your manner of your fifth house, in your romance, in how you deal with children, how you deal with your interests, how you deal with your education, is a very, very active energy, a very, very dynamic energy. You take a lot of effort in dealing with those areas of life, and you take a lot of focus also towards there, and you put in a lot of effort to get those areas to be successful also, or at least to take care of them. Similarly, the Aries energies also guides the ninth house in terms of higher education, how you deal with your gurus, how you deal with higher studies. And this also shows that you are somebody who are ready to struggle just to get higher degrees if you feel that is in your path of your goal or what you want to achieve. If not, then obviously the studies will not be of the highest order. Now, secondly, the fourth house is of Cancer energies, but the trine houses from the fourth house also are controlled by the same energy. And so, in the manifestation of the household, in your domestic life, you will be somebody who will be very caring, you will love your family, you will like to take care of your family, you will protect your family. But at the same time, you will have a very empathetic ear, a very understanding ear also to others who themselves are going through challenges, issues in life. You are ready to help others, you are ready to lend an helping ear or even a helping hand to others who go through challenges, issues themselves. Secondly, your family to a large extent may also, either if your placements in the Devan chart are strong, will help you and support you in your challenges, in various upheavals in life. Or if not well placed, your family may also be the reason for various obstructions, upheavals or challenges in your life. Secondly, even in matters of foreign lands, you may find good results there. You may even want to go abroad, or you may work with foreign companies also, and you will have a strong affinity to go abroad and live abroad and do well abroad, or you may end up working with foreign companies, foreign clients also. Then in your relationships, not only in your relationships will you have a Libra energy of taking everybody along, of keeping a balance in your relationship. However, even in your friend circle, in your social circle, the same Libra energy will also strongly influence that house, the manifestations and the results of that house, which means that you will also take a keen interest in developing relationships in your social circle. You will have a close relationship with your friends. If not more, then at least there will be one or two people in your social circle who will be close to you and who will also be your 4 o'clock or 4 a.m. friends. Similarly, even in how you deal with your younger siblings or even in your communication style, there is a lot of give and take. There is a dialogue rather than a monologue. It is not that you listen to me, you hear what I'm saying and you will have to do what I say. It is not like that. You are also very balanced in your communication. You are very balanced in how you deal with others. You are also very balanced in how you try to influence others. It is not my way or the highway, or let's together reach a conclusion. And then in how you work, in your career and how you make your wealth, the overarching energies are that of Capricorn, which means that you work very, very hard, you work very diligently, you try and work in a very structured and organized manner most of the time. This should also be corroborated and helped by the D1 chart. However, this is how generally most of the time you will be in your life. But not only will you be diligent, organized, structured in your work and disciplined, but even in making money, you will try to take a very structured approach, a very diligent approach, a very structured approach, and you will also want to have the financial security, keeping some money in the banks, and will try and plan your financial status well or financial situation very well. And at the same time, in matters of career, you may also be somebody who is very service oriented, and many people who are born in the Aries ascendant may end up in the Navmansh, may end up doing service or having a service bent of mind even when you're doing business. You may do business where you also want to help people, you want to support people, and you will also face a lot of competition, and you will overcome competition or you will face competition through a lot of diligent, organized, structured approach rather than jumping headlong into challenges and issues also. And many of your successes in your career will also come through overcoming competition rather than being given success on a platter. And that is being born in the Aries Navmansh as an ascendant. Now let's look at, if you are born in a Taurus ascendant in your Navmansh, what does this mean? It means that in your D1 chart, you were not born in any of these water signs of Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. So if you are born in your D1 chart in any of these ascendants, then in your Navmansh, you will definitely not have the Taurus ascendant, which means for a Taurus person, main energies that manifest how he approaches his life is either of the Taurus energies, or may also have the other energies of fire and also air energies apart from the earth energies, but there will be less manifestation of the water energies in a person's life if he has a Taurus Navmansh ascendant, unless his D1 chart shows a very, very strong presence of many planets in the water signs. So this is the inherent energy. Secondly, I've also said that the Kendra houses of the Navmansh are the ones which are the overarching energies which control most of the situations in your life, most of the manifestations of your life and most results, which means that for a person who has a Taurus ascendant in the Navmansh, the main energy is that of Taurus, Leo, Scorpio and Aquarius, and these are the energies which not only control the four Kendra houses and the Navmansh, but also the entire life and most situations of the life. Many faces he will face or she will face with these four type of energies. And hence, I have also said in my earlier video that the Kendras not only control their own houses, but also the trine houses from themselves, which means that the Taurus energies will not only take care of the Kendra or the Lagna, but also of the fifth house as well as the ninth house, which means the person who has the Taurus Navmansh will also, in how he deals with competition or with others, in a logical bent of mind, and how he makes his investment, will also do it with a lot of Taurus energies, which means that he will be very strong when he takes a decision about an investment. He will go headlong with it, he will take that decision, but it will be with a lot of logical reasoning rather than just going with somebody said, he said or she said. Lot of analysis will go into planning investments before he or she makes the investment. Secondly, in how they deal with their, in the matters of their love, also with children, they may sometimes, their children or their romantic liaison may complain that the Taurus person, I mean I'm talking about in the Navmansh, will be somebody who will be a little headstrong, and he will come across as little stubborn and also a little analytical. So this person will keep pushing his or her children with a lot of analysis, saying, and with a lot of logical and practical mindset, rather than pushing them to do something just because the person himself wants. And even in matters of love also, there will be a certain degree of planning in their head, a logic, there will be a logic even in their romance. Even when they fall in love with somebody, there will always be a strong reason, a logical and practical reason why they like a person, why they love a certain person. Secondly, in the matters of their higher education, in the matters of how they deal with guru, there will also be somebody who will also be very headstrong and stubborn in your studies, which means if they put a focus on something, they may be able to do it for long hours, unless their ninth house is afflicted in their D1 chart. And they will do this in a very structured manner, in a very organized manner, and they will persevere even when they face failures. They will not give up studies so very easily. If they like something and they want to do something, then they will also spend hours behind getting that thing done. Then in the matters of the fourth house, the fourth house of the domestic life is controlled by the Leo energies, which means that at home, the Taurus person may also come across as somebody who pushes the people in the house, maybe the family, the children and the spouse also, to do what he or she wants. But at the same time, these people also take accountability for the results of their house, how their house is. They will never blame only the spouse. They may show a little more leadership at home. They may also push their family to act in a certain manner, but they will also take a keen interest in the matters of the house and will also take accountability for the house. They will never, if there is something going wrong in the house, they will also take responsibility, though they may surely point fingers at others. And that same Leo energies will also carry forward into the 8th house, which means when they face any challenges in their life, they will also first take the accountability, they will take responsibility, and they will deal with challenges with a lot of responsible behavior. They will not allow somebody else to take the lead, but they will themselves volunteer, they will themselves come forward, or they will at least put up their hand and say, if you need any help, please let me know, I will surely help. And the same thing they also do in the matters of how they overcome losses, how they overcome challenges, and how they also deal with foreign clients or with foreign lands, or how they want to work abroad. If they work abroad, if they work in foreign companies, then they want to rise quickly to the top of the ladder without wasting any time. And if they find their growth is stagnant, then they are not happy, even in the best of companies. Then in the matters of their relationships, lot of Scorpio energies are controlling their relationships or will control their relationship, which means their relationship may go through a lot of ups and downs. It may not happen only because they are not able to get along with the spouse. That may be a reason. But generally, with somebody who has a Taurus ascendant Navmash, they will face situations in their life where it will tug on the strings of the relationship, and the relationship, both the spouses will have to come forward and handle that situation, will have to handle that issue rather than doing it alone. And the same Scorpio energies also guide or control how they deal with their friendship and how they deal with society. And so many times, even from their social network also, they may face a little pushback, or they may support people outside of their family in their network circle also, because they feel that they need to also reach out to their friends when their friends need that help. So their relationships with friends will also be based on how supportive they are, how caring they are, and how helpful they are. However, there will always be some friendships which also may challenge them. But to a lot of friends, outside friends, they may also come across as somebody who are also not very, very open, not very extrovert, but more introverted. And same thing in how they deal with the effort. Most of the time, their efforts will also go through ups and downs. It will not be easy for them. It will not be a cakewalk for them. When they put in efforts, lot of effort will have to be put in to achieve something, and that too, the effort will go through lots of ups and downs, which means sometimes they will get success, and then suddenly for a period of time they will get no success or stagnated, and then suddenly they will get some success again, but again they will find that. So the roller coaster ride will continue for them. However, if they do business, then they will get success in the business after a lot of hard work, after a lot of effort. And then how will they make the money, how their careers will turn out? The Taurus ascendant native and the Navmansh will have a very social approach to work, and they usually may work with some cause in mind, some agenda in their mind also, whichever industry they may be working with. And the same energies, the Aquarius energies of dealing with people with a higher cause, with a higher agenda, also controls how they make money and how also they do service. Which means that when they make money, they also have a large mindset, which means they don't mind working very hard and to be able to achieve success over a period of time. However, they will want to plan their success, and even the money that they earn, there will be some cause, there will be some plan to the money. So they, at the back of their mind or even in their diaries, they will write down, there will be a plan what they want to do with the money. And they will also involve their family and communicate with the family in their plans. Same thing in the matters of service also. They will deal with people in their company, in their team, with as an equal. They will help and support them. And even in their competition or their enemies, they will treat them with a lot of respect. And they will overcome a lot of challenges in their life because of the ability to make a relationship. And that is the manifestation of the Taurus ascendant native in the Navman chart. Now for a Gemini ascendant native, if you are born in any of these water signs, which is Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces in the D1 chart, then you may not end up in the Navman's chart as the ascendant being Gemini. Now, I have said this before in my earlier video also, that the four main Kendra houses in the Navman's chart are the overarching energies of how the person's entire life is controlled, rather than only the Navman's or the houses in the Navman's. Which means that overarching energies for a Gemini person in the Navman chart are Gemini, Virgo, Sagittarius and Pisces. These four energies control the entire life, unless there is a specific house in the D1 chart which has a lot of planets placed in it, so that will also manifest itself. However, the main energy at a 70,000 feet level, you can say, are these four overarching energies. What does this mean? It means that in his life, in general decisions, in his effort and how he gets results, this person will be somebody who will achieve through a lot of interaction, through a lot of communication, through a lot of thought, and a lot of thought where sometimes there is also some confusion in their mind, what should I do and what should I not do. And only after due thought and after going back and forth in their minds many times before they ultimately take a decision. And this energy does not only guide the or rule the lagna or manifest the lagna or how they think or how they act, but also the trine houses from the lagna, which means in the manner of how they deal with children, in the manner of romance, in the manner of education also, the Gemini energies control even their romance or their children or the investments, which means in how they will make their investments also, they will think through, and they will also sometimes have doubts whether I should money in mutual fund, should I put money in shares or something else, and only after due thought and going back and forth over the decision will they ultimately take the decision of where to invest their money in. Secondly, in how they deal with children also, many a times they will also deal with children as an equal, and they will have a lot of balance in giving a lot of choices to their children also. And same thing in their love affair also. Firstly, they may have doubts once they get into a relationship. Is this relationship for keeps? Is this relationship, or will this relationship support me and help me, serve me or not? So there will be thought in the back of their mind, but once they decide, they will treat the romantic liaison or the partner as an equal, and they will also involve them in a lot of decision making. And same Gemini energies will also be guiding their high education. They may think through, they may have doubts in their minds which degree to go for, which institute to join and so on. However, once they decide, they will keep a lot of focus, and they may have a lot of interaction also in the education with their teachers. There will also be a lot of give back and forth. They will be witty, they will be communicative, and some of these will leave a strong mark on their teachers, and their teachers and their gurus may remember them for a long time. Then in the matters of the home, of the house, these people have a lot of Virgo energies which control their household, which means at home they will be a little analytical, where things are placed, how they deal with their spouse, how they deal with the children, which house to go for, which house to invest in or where to stay. There will be a lot of planning going in that, and those Virgo energies will also control how they deal with the 8th house energies in their lives. So how they will overcome or face obstructions, challenges, issues in their life will also be with a lot of Virgo energies, which means in matters of emergencies or challenges also, they will be quick thinking on their feet, and even there they will do a lot of analysis, which hospital to go to, for example, which doctor to approach, whether to do the surgery or not, whether to invest in this particular aspect or not, whether to claim insurance or not. So they will, even there they will make analytical decisions. If they want to take insurance, they will weigh many pros and cons, talk to number of people, weigh where they are paying less premium for, and eventually they'll take a decision. Same thing, they will also be very analytical how they deal with money, especially how they spend. They will think through every penny. If they spend money, suddenly they may spend a lot of money. However, they may pinch pennies also. They may also try to keep some money away for a rainy day, because they are always in doubt about the money. They are in doubt whether they are getting enough money or not. They are in doubt whether they are spending more. They are in doubt whether their money is safe or not also. And so these people are also who at least try to save money, even if they don't earn much. And in dealing with foreign clients and also working in large companies, one of the key decisions will also be how much money they are making in the contribution that they make. Then in matters of relationship, a person with a Gemini ascendant native will deal with a lot of Sagittarius energies, which means this person will be a lot of fun in his life. He or she will also be a little adventurous, which means they will not think too much when they are going into a relationship. So they are, because if they think they have enough information, they will jump into the relationship, and they don't mind the roller coaster ride also. They will have fun on the way also. They are witty, they are communicative, and they like to do a lot of fun activities with their partners. And the same Sagittarius energies also control how they lead their social life. They are very active in their social life. They are very dynamic also. They will have many friends across the strata, though the very close friends will be one or two. And they will also be in touch with a lot of people, and they will like to do a lot of fun activities. They like to go to pubs. They may like to dine and eat outside also, and go on trips also with friends. They will also be very, very helpful to friends, and they don't mind traveling to meet friends also. Many a time they may end up traveling more out of station to meet their friends and inviting them over, rather than being stagnant at their house and not doing anything. And the same Sagittarius energies also guides how they put in the effort. They don't mind putting in a lot of effort. They don't mind putting in long hours, but at the same time, they also, when they do put in some effort, they also want to have a fun element to it, an adventurous element to it, rather than it being dull and drab. Anything which is dull and drab will not be able to keep the attention for long. Then how they work and how they earn their livelihood and their money. Here a lot of Pisces energies will control them, which means they are very dreamy in how much money I need to make. They will make large plans, and they may have thought through for the next 10 years, though at the back of the mind, because of being born in the Gemini ascendant in the Navmanch, there will also be doubts how much money they can make, where they can make from, which career to join, which industry to join, because they are not always sure. But because they are very idealistic also, they are very, very optimistic also, they may jump into and take up an offer, especially when they feel that it appeals to their emotions, because the Pisces energies are also controlling to a large extent the second house energies where Cancer is placed, which means they will be emotional about their money also, yet they will be very optimistic also. And so many times in their careers and their jobs also, they will take a very optimistic and emotional decision, though they will think that the decision they are taking is very analytical. And the same Pisces energies also control how they deal with in their service. They will be ready to serve a lot of people even when they don't know them very well. Of course, they will be the first people to reach out to friends when the friend is in trouble, and they are idealistic about it. They feel that they need to take accountability and they need to reach out to their friends first, because it is their responsibility also, and then when needed, their friends may also approach them to help them also when the time arises. And they also have a very idealistic way of how to deal with competition. They may not manipulate too much, though they will be a little secretive of how they manage their relationship also. And that is the manifestation of a person in the Gemini ascendant in the Navmanch. A Cancer ascendant native in the Navmanch chart will be somebody who will not be born in the Gemini, Libra or Aquarius ascendant in the D1 chart. If somebody is born in the Gemini, Libra or Aquarius ascendant in the D1 chart, then definitely they may not have a Cancer ascendant in the Navmanch, which means that the Cancer ascendant native in the Navmanch will be to a large extent have the air, the fire energies, the earth energies or the water energies, but may have less of the air energies, how they deal with their life, how they approach situations, unless they have more planets placed in these signs in the D1 chart. And these four Kendra houses, the first, fourth, seventh and tenth, are the ones that those sign energies control their entire lives, rather than only the four Kendra houses. And that's why each of the Lagna, each of the Kendra houses also control or manifest the same energy to the other trines also from themselves, which means the Lagna having the Cancer sign or the Cancer energies will also deal with the fifth house energies or the fifth house areas with the same Cancer energies to a large extent, And same thing in terms of dealing with their gurus, the teachers, and also higher education. Which means when they deal with the children, they are very emotional about their children, they are very close to their children, and they will put the kids first rather than put themselves first. And whenever the kids run into challenges, run into issues, they will be the ones who run out to help them first. Same thing in the matters of romance also, they will put the partner first and themselves next. Which means whenever the partner needs help and support, they will reach out to them. And the Cancer person is also attracted more towards people who are themselves very secretive and very magnetic, having Scorpio energies here. But because being overarching energies being that of Cancer, so their attraction is towards people who are more magnetic, and they fall in love with them and they take care of them and they support them also. And the same energies of Cancer is related to the high education also. If something doesn't appeal to their hearts, doesn't appeal to their minds, even if that area of the industry is very lucrative, they may not take up that high education definitely. If they take up something against their will, that may be only because of circumstances rather than their own choice. They will also take up a education which they can relate to, and usually they may also form a strong bond with at least one or two teachers in their life and maybe even be in touch with them for a long period of time. In the matters of the home, in the matters of how they deal in the domestic world, in the domestic life, they will have a lot of Libra energies controlling, which means they at home, they will seek counsel from their spouse, counsel from their family, and only after talking to them, dealing them with them is the equal, will they take decisions also. And same thing in terms of how they will also invest in property also. And the same Libra energies will also control the 8th house, which means when they have to deal with challenges and issues in their life, they will try to take along people in their relationship, which means they will also have, they may always have their spouse standing by them, their family standing by them when they go into challenges and issues. And the same thing, they will also treat people who themselves are going through challenges and issues, because they feel they have a responsibility towards people who are going through issues and challenges. And in dealing with them, they will also deal with them as an equal. So even if they're dealing with somebody who is poor and not able to take decisions, yet the Cancer person will deal with them as an equal, get them along, get their agreement before taking a decision for them or before helping them. And same thing, how they deal with the expenses, how they deal with foreign lands and having any association with foreign lands or working for foreign lands, because the Cancer ascendant native and the Navbanj will have a equal relationship even with their foreign colleagues, which means they work on relationships. And if they are not able to align themselves or not be able to connect with those clients or with the company or with the heads, then they don't feel at home, at ease, even in foreign companies or foreign lands or with foreign clients. In the matters of how they deal with relationships, here they take relationship more as a duty also. So a lot of activities they do at home with their spouse will also be not only because they love and care for the spouse, but they also feel it's their duty and their responsibility to do that. And the same energies, Capricorn energies, also guide their social life and their money making endeavors also. Same thing, the effort also. So in how they socialize, they feel it's important to socialize every now and then. They need to socialize with their families. So they may even plan which day of the week or month they may want to call over their friends, or they may want to go out with friends, and when they want to socialize. And if they don't feel happy in that environment, they may also take a back seat very quickly. And same thing, how they put in the effort, they will put in long hours of effort, they will put in lot of hard work to get results, and they may persevere for a long period of time and with a lot of analytical approach. So when they put in effort, they will see, is my hard work giving me fruits? If not, they will also try to rethink, reanalyze, and only if they feel that it is serving them, they will put in the effort, or they will better focus on something else. In matters of how they make money, how they make their finances, and where they work and how they deal with their job or their career, Here they have a lot of Aries energies, which means they are very, very motivated about their job. They are very, very motivated how they work in, and they work with people with a lot of dedication and a lot of motivation and willpower, especially when connected to money as well as to service. The same Aries energies comes to the fore. So in dealing with money, they will deal with them with money issues, with a lot of responsibility. When they take up a project or take up an offer from the company, they're deep into it, whether they are getting enough money, whether they are getting paid equal. So they will also take their remuneration as a matter of respect also, because they feel if they don't make a respectable amount which is equal to others in their team, only then will they take it up. If they feel they're getting paid less than the other members in the team, then they feel slighted also and they may not like it. Sometimes they may make a decision to move out of the company because they feel they are not being treated fairly. That's how they treat money and their livelihood also, where it connects to work. And the same approach they also take in service. In service also, they are very dedicated. They have a lot of strong motivation to do their tasks well. However, they also like to have fun at work. So when they are working at office, they will also bring in a lot of fun element. They will also not work in a very dreary environment. They will like to spice it up, and they will make it a fun way to work with people, to deal with people, and they may take risks also. And that's how they are even with their competition. People who compete with them at work, they will also have friendship with them. They may also socialize with them, and they will win over their enemies with their friendliness. And that is how the results will manifest for a Cancer ascendant in the Navmanch. For a Leo ascendant native in the Navmanch horoscope as an ascendant, you will find that people who are born in the Gemini, Libra, or Aquarius ascendant in the D1 chart or the Lagna chart will not have a Navmanch horoscope or Navmanch Lagna, which is in Leo. Which means the ascendant or the person who has a Navmanch horoscope will be able to showcase or demonstrate a lot of fire energies, earth energies, and even water energies in various areas of his life rather than the air energies. Unless there are more planets in these signs, Gemini, Libra and Aquarius in the D1 chart. And the Lagna energies as well as the other three Kendra energies are the ones which are the guiding factors and the overarching factors how they lead their life and how they manifest results. Which means that the trine houses from each of the Kendra houses are also controlled by the same energies rather than the other energies of the houses itself. And hence the fire energies of Leo of the Lagna chart will also to a large extent will be how they deal with the fifth house energies of children in their love and romance as well as in their high education and how they deal with their teachers. Which means that in their romantic liaisons or with children, they take up a lot of responsibility also. So they will take a lot of responsibility for the children. They will also take ownership of their investments, and they will also take up responsibility in the romantic liaison. However, sometimes the romantic partner may complain that they are somebody who sometimes are very narcissistic or even arrogant and sometimes try to rule them. However, they have a lot of Sagittarius energies and how they deal with the romantic liaison as well as the children, even while trying to deal with them with leadership, with responsibility, more accountability also. And in the matters of higher education, they will take a lot of responsible decisions in their higher education, and this will be something that they will think through before they take up any high education, high degree, because they also feel it's a matter of their prestige also and whether they will attain a stature in life, any status in life through the high education. If they find that whatever high education, whatever high degree they take may not add much to their prestige in society, their standing in society, it will not serve them well, then they may take a back seat and they may not deal with that. And they may also have a very strong relationship with the teachers, with the gurus, where they may also be a pet of some teachers or gurus, where they take responsibility for some of the help and support that the gurus also need. So sometimes the teachers and their gurus may also fall back on them to help them. In the matters of how they deal with the matters of domestic life, a lot of Scorpio energies will be the guiding factor and the controlling factor for them in their domestic life, which means in their domestic life they may also go through ups and downs, challenges and obstructions also. And with a lot of high degree of self-motivation and energy and hard work, they may be able to keep their relationship and their domestic life with a lot of peace and with happiness. However, how they deal with the matters of the 8th house, which means sudden obstacles, sudden challenges also, will be with a lot of Scorpio energies, which means that they at first may get overwhelmed by the challenge that comes in, the situation that comes up, which may overawe them. However, then they take control of the situation and then they'll deal with the situation with their own mannerism, with their own effort, with their own thoughts. And many times how they deal with situations and emergencies may not be easily understood by their spouse or their family members also, because they may be also be come across as leaders in tough situations, and they may also be dealing with a lot of idealism with how they deal with others who themselves are going through challenges and issues. How they deal with money issues, with expenses may also be where the expenses also go through ups and downs. So they save some money for a rainy day and suddenly something comes up and their savings get wiped out. Again they put in some monies and they try to save it. So that keeps on happening and they rarely are able to save very high amount of money, because some or the other reason becomes the reason for them to be able to spend money. And usually these are for more emotional reasons. They spend money on family or for a cause rather than on very very lavish expenses. If there is a lavish expense which they suddenly pay money for, that will be because they emotionally get attached to that, because they love it, they fall in love with a car, they fall in love with a house, they just want it, and then they may go through that expense only to regret it later. Then in the matter of their relationships, they have a lot of Aquarius energies in how they deal with energies, with relationship, which means that they will have a higher, they will always look at the bigger picture. Sometimes they may miss the trees for the woods because they are looking at things at a bigger picture. And small things on a day-to-day basis which keep the relationship intact, which keep the relationship happy, they may be missing out, because of which sometimes the spouse may complain that small things you don't do. The Leo ascendant native in the Navmash may end up doing big things, large things. So in a month or two, he may do a big action which he or she feels is very important for the relationship. However, on a day-to-day, small things are something which their eye misses. And that's how they deal with the social life also. They feel that in their social life, they need to look at the bigger picture. And so they have friends across the board. They don't mind people from different communities, different strata of society, because they look at the larger picture that we need to enjoy us with social circle. We may need to have varied people in a social circle rather than be too picky. So they will be very outgoing, and even in their social interactions, sometimes they socialize also with people who they think like them and also support the same causes. If somebody doesn't support or doesn't believe in the same cause that the Leo ascendant person in the Navmash feels, then they have limited friendship with them. Then in the matters of how they deal with their money or their careers, the Leo ascendant person in the Navmash, in their careers or their jobs also, may look at money making or their livelihood very analytically, which means money will be the guiding factor, but a lot of logic and a lot of practicality will be the reason why they will take up a job and they will take a decision to join a certain entity or do a certain business. And after a lot of reasoning only, then they will take up that offer or they will take up that job or they will indulge in some business. And that's how they will also be in service. They will come across a little stubborn with their team members also, and they may have some challenges with one or two team members also. However, they may also serve some cause with either contribution of money or when money is involved, or sometimes they may also get into debts because of money. And that's how the various situations will manifest for a Leo ascendant native in the Navman. For a Virgo ascendant native, as an ascendant in the Navman chart, these people will be the people who will may not be born in the Gemini or Libra or Aquarius ascendant in the D1 chart. That means that if a person is born in a Gemini or Libra or Aquarius ascendant as a Lagna chart in the D1 chart, then they will not have a Navmanch where the ascendant is that of Virgo. So the main energies for the Virgo ascendant native in the Navmanch will be of earth energies, of fire energies, of water energies in most of the situations in life, unless they have a number of planets in the Gemini, Libra or Aquarius signs in the Lagna chart. And these four main Kendra houses, those sign energies are also the energies which control their lives, various situations, various probabilities and various results, rather than all the energies playing their part. I have also made a video around this. So the Virgo energies, the Gemini energies, the Sagittarius energies and the Pisces energies will be the overarching energies which control the life of a person who was born or who has a Virgo ascendant in the Navmanch. And the trine energies also are controlled by the Kendra houses, which means that the 5th house and the 9th house also are controlled to a large extent by the Virgo energies, which means in how the person deals with the matters of romance or matters of children or in matters of investments, a lot of Virgo energies of practicality and logic and thinking through and analysis will come to the fore. So when they deal with children, they will also deal with children in a very logical, very practical but very analytical manner also. There will be a lot of things which they may also try to correct in their children. And sometimes the children may also complain that the parents are too controlling or trying to correct them all the time rather than let them be. Same thing may also happen with the romantic liaison for a person who has the Virgo ascendant native. The partner may feel that the person is trying to control himself a lot, control him or her a lot, trying to correct them a lot, and is always complaining. And so this is something which the Virgo ascendant native in the Navmanch has to curb a little bit. However, they are very, very committed to their relationship. They are very committed and responsible about their children, about their investments also. And even in the investments, they may take a lot of logical and practical approach, but they will also put in a lot of hard work to be able to get better results out of their investments. And similarly, they will put in a lot of hard work in dealing with children, in matters of children, in matters of education, and also give a lot of time and attention to their romantic liaison, romantic partner as well. And the same thing they may also bring about in their education. In their education, they will also approach the education with a logical thought, with a lot of practical thought, with a lot of thought through decisions, which means they will think through a lot of which degree to take, which higher degree to pursue, which higher qualification to pursue. And it will not be an emotional decision, but a very logical, thought through, analytical decision what to pursue, what to take up, which university to take admission in. In the matters of their domestic life, they may also be people where the Sagittarius energies will control their domestic life as well as the 12th house and 8th house, which means at home they will be a lot of fun to be with, fun to interact, and there will always be something happening in their house, a lot of dynamism in the house also. And this person may also want to go out with the family, travel to different places but with family, and rarely wants to go alone. And so many times they travel to foreign lands also and far off places also to visit, and some of those visits may also be spiritual. They may also have a lot of friends abroad or in foreign lands and foreign connections, and that's how they also deal with their emergencies and challenges of the 8th house of sudden obstruction, the obstacles come, which means that they will not be too overawed by this challenge and the issue. They may in fact find something to even smile even when the things are not going according to what they would want things to shape out as. So they will put in a lot of effort also to overcome the challenges and issues, but they will also deal with it with a lot of practical approach, with a lot of reasonable approach, with a lot of thought through approach, and they will also learn from those experiences of obstacles and challenges also, and they may seek wise counsel also rather than do only their bidding. But definitely they will be the least overwrought people in emergencies, and they may also find something to even smile at. Same thing in their expenses. They may be a little adventurous in their expenses also, may sometimes go overboard also in their traveling, in the expenses also. Sometimes they may also find education in foreign lands, or they may find some qualification which is also abroad, which also helps them to be able to find more leadership roles. So if they think, or they think that a certain degree may help them to grow in their careers, grow higher in their careers, then they may take it. In their relationships, the Virgo ascendant native will have a lot of Pisces energies, which means they will have a lot of idealism in how they deal with the spouse, how they deal with others. But they will also be somebody who will be more giving, more caring also in how they approach relationships. While they are also very balanced, but sometimes emotions get the better of them and they end up doing more for others or giving more for others rather than getting back. So many a time they end up serving the relationship more rather than getting served also as a return. And the same approach they also have with their social circle, with their friend circle also, that they are more caring, they are more giving, they are more idealistic also, assuming they will also be helped by the same friends when they need help. However, they find that they end up spending more effort, more time, more energy, more trust in friends or the social network, and they are less reciprocated back. So many times they are the receiving end because of getting too emotionally attached with friends and being too optimistic of how friends may help them, and that is also something that they regret later. And in dealing with their hard work, they put in a lot of hard work, they put in a lot of dedication, but many times their work, their hard work goes through many ups and downs, it runs into obstacles, into challenges also, and only after a lot of hard work they find some success, only to find that it seems to have stagnated, and then again after a lot of hard work over years suddenly they get some success. So the efforts rarely give them a stabilized results over a period of time. There is always a roller coaster ride, even where the hard work, the efforts are concerned. Then how they deal with money matters, how they deal at work, and where do they make the money from. In matters of career, many times they are very dual minded also, which means they may take up a job only to think through, is this job right for me, is this profile right for me, is this company right for me, is this something which will serve me in the long run. So even while joining a company and working there, even maybe after a year or two, they start to develop cold feet, they start to develop doubts whether they will grow enough, or they are growing fast enough, or they are always looking over the shoulder, or thinking whether they are being overlooked by their spouse, by their bosses, by the supervisors for growth. And growth is something very, very important for them to be able to earn money. And earning money is very important for them as a responsibility also. So in earning money also, they think a lot about family and taking care of the family or doing more for family. And they also want to have a balance in expenses in their family, and hence they also want to earn more because they would like to contribute more and be the biggest support in family. And so many times their decisions to work in a certain career will also be based on how the certain branding of the company is, whether the company is a big brand, the company is an MNC, then they may find it easier to join a company where they can have more confidence. So confidence in a certain brand, in a certain industry, is critical for them to join a company. And the same way they also approach their service, how they approach what career to take up, what vocation to take up, what industry to join, and they always look at the big picture in their service also. And so many times at work, in competition, they will overlook small challenges with colleagues, and they will focus on the big picture, and they'll try to keep the relationship intact. And many times they may not even say what is in their hearts to colleagues, and will keep it to themselves, and they will hence be able to get along with a variety of people because they look at the big picture and they don't care about small issues, who's coming from which caste, who's coming from which area, they don't mind that. And that is how the manifestations, and that is how a Virgo ascendant native in the Navmansh manifests. For a Libra ascendant native, as the ascendant in the month, you will find that those people who are born in the D1 Lagna in Taurus, Virgo or Capricorn will not have the ascendant which is of Libra in the Navman's chart. Which means that for a Libra ascendant native in the Navman's, the overarching energies of how they manifest results in their life, including their relationships, will be based a lot on the air energies, the fire energies or the water energies and less of the earth energies. Unless they have a lot of planets in the Taurus, Virgo or Capricorn sign in the Lagna chart. And these central energies of the four Kendras of Libra, Capricorn, Aries and Cancer will also be their guiding factor for them in their entire life rather than just the four Kendras. Which means the Libra energies which is controlling the Lagna in the Navmanch will also control the trine houses from it. And hence they will also in the matters of dealing with children, in the love affairs and how they make investments, equality and balance will be something which will guide them. Which means that in dealing with their spouse or in dealing with their romantic liaison or their girlfriend or boyfriend or who they are dating, they will look at the big picture, they will avoid small details and they will give them an equal treatment. They will give them equal time, they will also take up equal responsibility for them, as well as give more choices, equal choices to the opposite person, not only in the romantic liaison, even with children, because they feel even children should be allowed to make mistakes and they should be allowed to grow through mistakes. And that's how they also make their investments. They may, many a times their investments may go into certain companies or endeavors where they have some acquaintances there. Sometimes they are guided by a friend who says invest in this stock or invest in this property. Then they take that word and then they invest in that particular venture. And even in that, they look at the big picture. They are generally looking at the long-term picture rather than a short-term picture. And the same Libra energies also guide their education. When they take up any degree, then they take up that degree thinking long ahead, thinking of much into the future, whether it will be something which will serve them in the long run, which will also help them work with people or for people or with people. And so many times their education is also in a certain industry where they have to work with people in close quarters. And dealing with people and working closely with people manifests the career for them also. And generally these people also have good relationship with gurus or even with their father, unless they find a lot of challenges with gurus or with the father because of many malefics in their Lagna chart in the ninth house. Now in their domestic life, the domestic life will be controlled a lot by the Capricorn energies, which means that the domestic life will not only have Capricorn energies as a guiding factor but also the trine houses from them. So in their domestic life, lot of dedication, lot of commitment, lot of patience and lot of perseverance will be the reason why the relationships will be very very stable and over a long period of time. These people will not break off a relationship easily but will like to sustain with it for a long period of time unless something goes really drastically wrong. And same dedication and commitment they also show when they face challenges in life. Especially when connected to sudden obstacles, sudden challenges, they will take a lot of responsibility and they will have a lot of patience and they will deal with challenges with a lot of patience even when suddenly at the start being a little overawed. And they will persevere over a period of time to be able to overcome that in a very structured, in a very organized, in a very practical manner. And the same way they also work on the expenses. All the expenses will be very planned, they will be very organized and they will be very analytical about where their money is going. Sometimes they will also pinch pennies because they are that kind of analytical about the expenses also. And in dealing with foreign clients or dealing with foreign companies or working abroad also, they work with a lot of hard work, with a lot of commitment, with a lot of diligence, and over a period of time with their patience, with their perseverance, they also do very well and they also get success in foreign lands mostly because of how they work with a lot of commitment and what kind of impression they leave on the client or in their bosses or the supervisors. In their relationship, they have a lot of Aries energies, which means they take a lot of interest in their domestic life, in their romantic life, or in their marital life especially. Same thing in dealing with others, same thing even with dealing with team workers at work, which means they will give a lot of time to their home, they will give a lot of time to the partner, and they will take a keen interest in the matters of the partner also. They will also give a keen ear to the partners, listen to them, and also help them and support them. So if the partner says they're facing some challenge at work, they will immediately start to advise them, try to give them a solution, try to give them a helping hand, sometimes even when not asked to. And same approach they have in the social life also. They take a lot of keen interest in their social life because they feel they also have a lot of responsibility towards friends also. So they will put in a lot of effort, they will take in a lot of interest in the social life, in the matters of friends. And if the friends are in challenges, they will also take responsibility and they will also take accountability for them also and look out for them, be very, very active for them, and they will be the first people to rush when friends face a challenge. They will be a 4 a.m. friend to many, though in return they may not have so many 4 a.m. friends coming to help them. And same thing they will do in the matters of effort. They will work very, very hard with a lot of dedication, but there will also be a lot of little fun element and how they want to work, how they communicate also. If they are not having fun while they are working very, very hard, then they tend to lose their interest very, very quickly. So they are working very, very hard, and if they are not connected to what's happening, they are not having fun, then they lose interest. And many times they also, those endeavors which they take upon themselves or they want to do on their own, or they go on their own to do something rather than working for others, if they find that is not fun, they are not able to keep their interest, they may also back off. And so many times they go through two or three different businesses to succeed in before they get the eventual success. And in matters of how they work and where their careers manifest and how they earn their money, a lot of Cancer energies are the ones which control their careers, which means that in the matters of earning money, they also tend to sometimes take more emotional decisions, which means if money is good and they can relate to the cause of the company, then they'll take up that project, they will take up that job. However, many times because of getting too emotional about giving in to the supervisors will convince them to stay without getting growth also, which means that their earnings then go through an ups and downs in careers, which means they may fall back behind others who are at the same level, or their colleagues, or their partners, or their friends who are doing much better than them in terms of earning, and they feel they are left behind many a times because of taking emotional decisions in careers, or listening or giving into the pleas and the requests of their supervisors and their managers rather than taking very practical, logical decisions. And same thing they do, how they work in the service also. In their careers, in their work, and how they serve others, a lot of idealism is involved, a lot of optimism is involved, a lot of care thought is involved, a lot of empathy is involved. So many times such people may also take up a vocation which is related to supporting others, caring for others, helping others, standing by for others rather than taking the lead. So a lot of such people may be related in hospitality industry, in the medical field, in the pharmaceutical energy fields, in the software fields, in the accounts field, in the financial fields also. But they will also support their colleagues, and when asked for help by their colleagues, even competition, they may not bat an eyelid and come to the help of even those competitors at work or their team members. And that's how the results will manifest for a Libra ascendant native in the Navmanch. For a Scorpio ascendant native as the Lagna in the Navmanch, you will find that those people who are born in the Taurus, Virgo or Capricorn ascendants in the D1 chart, or they have the Lagna of Taurus, Virgo or Capricorn in the D1 chart, they are not born with the ascendant being Scorpio in the Navmanch. So the person with Scorpio as ascendant in the Navmanch chart will work with a lot of fire energies or air energies or water energies, but less with the earth energies. unless they have a lot of planets in the Taurus, Virgo or Capricorn sign in the D1 chart. And the Kendras, the Scorpio energy, the Aquarius energies, the Taurus energies and the Leo energies are the ones which control most of their areas of their life, even those houses which are trine houses from each of the Kendra houses, which means the Scorpio energies of the Lagna also influences the fifth house of children, of romance, of investments, as well as the ninth house of higher education, relationship with gurus and travel. So this person's life definitely is a life of ups and downs and challenges, but even in how they deal with romance, they may also have the romantic life going through ups and downs, where suddenly something happens because of which the romantic liaison gets into challenges and issues, and they have to work hard to be able to extricate themselves out of the issues. Same thing in matter of dealing with children. Many times children get into some challenges or issues and they rush to them to help them, rather than allowing the children to learn through their own mistakes. The investments also go through upheavals, ups and downs, because many times their investments get into some losses, and only after some initial losses, ups and downs, do they eventually make it good in their investments. They are not so very lucky in their investments, and generally the investments don't give them as good fruits as others. And the same thing happens in the higher education as well. Their higher education also goes through ups and downs. It's not a very smooth path for them to get highly educated or get their qualification. There will always be some or the other roadblock which stop their education. And in matter of education also, many times they take very emotional decisions when connected to higher decisions also, or getting higher qualifications also. And they also develop affiliations to their father or to their gurus also. They find themselves very connected. They find sometimes even emotionally connected to their father or to their parents, and even to their mother, in fact higher than the others, and also to some guru, even a spiritual guru whom they find themselves to be strongly connected. In the matters of the domestic life, they are guided by the Aquarius energies, which means that the Aquarius energies are the ones which are the controlling factors, not only at home but also in the matters of the 8th house and the 12th house. What does this mean? Which means in the home, they always look at the big picture, and they are not too nitpicky about what's happening in the home. They will not complain too much for things which are not exactly prim and proper. They will look at the larger part. If they feel they have a understanding spouse, a loving spouse, they have a good family, then they will not delve too much into spouse didn't do this for me, spouse said this, and so on. They avoid the small things. They focus on the big picture, because of which they get very stable relationships at home. Same thing happens in their ups and downs in their lives, and their obstacles in life, and the issues also in life, where they try to look at the big picture. When some challenge happens in their life, they don't sit down holding their heads in their hands thinking, why did this happen to me? They start to analyze things. They start to look at the big picture, why certain things came about, and they also like to talk about it. Sometimes they also have this doubt, why did this happen? Did I do something wrong? And many times it may also happen, the challenge may also happen, because they forgot to look at the fine print. But they deal with the challenges and issues with life with a lot of perseverance, looking at the big picture, and they support the causes of a lot of other people also who themselves run into challenges. And the same way they look at the expenses also. Sometimes if they are saving big money on the larger items, then they are happy, and sometimes they miss the pennies for the pounds, which means that they try to save pounds, the large amounts they may try to save, and sometimes they end up getting the expenses overboard because of spending too many of the smaller expenses which they are not able to control. And this sometimes happens because in relationships, if they go for an outing, they will not think too much about spending money on the outing, on a dinner, on a shopping spree, but they may try to spend to save money on the larger expenses or the larger investments, only to realize that their day-to-day expenses are much higher because they are not pinching pennies. Then in the relationships, a lot of Taurus energies control not only their relationship but also their social life, and also how they put in the effort. So at home, in the relationship, sometimes they may come across to the partner as stubborn, though the person with the Scorpio ascendant native feels that
what I am saying is good for everyone. And my partner should listen to me. Why is the partner not listening to me? Because I mean good for the partner. However, because they come across as little stubborn, even arrogant, their relationship sometimes runs into challenges. And here, many times they make a mistake around the money part. They sometimes either are too giving in the money part, they don't control their finances, their spouse may end up getting more out of their own hard work of the Scorpio person. However, sometimes they may pinch pennies too much in their relationship. So they either go completely overboard how much they allow their fiancé or their wife or their spouse to control the expenses. Sometimes they may be too penny pinching. And so this also creates frictions in the marriage. And the same thing happens even with the social life. Sometimes they tend to give unsolicited advice to friends because they're too analytical about their friends, their social circle also. If a friend tells them something about what he or she did, then they'll start telling them what they did wrong, what they should have done, and then they will also tell them strongly what they should do, almost forcing them from the friend's perspective of what to do, what not to do. Though the Scorpio ascendant native may not see that way. Same thing when they put in the effort, they will put in the effort and a lot of hard work with a lot of dedication and commitment, but they will also look at the financial part. If they feel they're putting in a lot of effort, but they are not being paid enough in terms of monetary benefit or any fruits of their labor, then they start to have doubts whether they should put in that much of commitment and dedication for something which is not serving them. Then how do they make their money? Most of the money that they make or their careers they do is about how they feel responsible for an area, responsible for a decision or a certain industry. And whether that will help them to really grow in the corporate ladder or not, will it help them to achieve higher success and higher position and higher designation? That's how they also take their money matters or their decisions around income. If they feel that they will grow higher, they will get a good designation, they will get a responsible position, then they don't mind compromising on the money part also. However, when they work, they also want to have fun at work. They also want to have a very lively environment. They want to have an environment which also pushes them, also challenges them. When there is a lot of problem solving which is involved, then they enjoy their work more, they feel more responsible, and they take the leadership at work. Same thing in how they do service with other colleagues, how they face competition. In their competition, they are very, very motivated and they will take responsibility for their own effort when sitting for competitive exam or when dealing with colleagues. And many times they help their colleagues and even their competition in other departments because they feel they are responsible for them also, and it is their duty also to help others. And that's how the relationships and the career and the various results will manifest for a Scorpio ascendant native in the Navmanch. Now for a Sagittarius ascendant native as the Lagna in the Navmanch, these people are the ones who will not be born in the Taurus, Virgo or Capricorn ascendants in the D1 chart or the Lagna. Which means that if somebody has a Lagna of Taurus, Virgo or Capricorn in the D1 chart, then they may not have a Navmanch where the ascendant is that of Sagittarius. So the Sagittarius ascendant native in the Navmanch will have a lot of energies of either fire, air or water as the main energies how he or she manifests their life, and less of earth energies unless they have a lot of planets in the Taurus, Virgo or Capricorn sign in the Lagna chart. Their main life energy is Sagittarius. However, the Kendra energies, the sign energies also control the entire horoscope rather than only the Kendras, which means the Sagittarius, the Virgo, the Gemini and the Pisces energies of the Kendras rule the entire life, rule the entire horoscope. And this is also manifested by each of the Kendras also controlling the respective trine houses. So the same energies of Sagittarius, energies of the Lagna also override or manifest over how they deal with children, how do they deal with investments, how they deal with their romantic liaison. So if they find somebody who's fun to work with, we deal with, and then only they may want to have a romantic relationship with the person. If the person that they like is not fun to be with, fun to deal with, fun to talk with, fun to travel with, then such a relationship may not survive for long. And that is how they are with children also. They are always smiling, laughing, playing with the children, going out with children, spending time at home with children. So when they come home, they don't want to sit in a corner and do something of their own. They want to deal with children, have fun with children, talk to children, what's happening. And they also like to spend a lot of time with their romantic partner. And same thing with in the investments. They are high risk takers. They are adventurers also in the investments, and many times they also lose money because of being too adventurous and too trusting in the investments also. And the same energies they also bring into their higher education, where they take up those degrees which they feel they may like to do, they may have fun to do, and this will also be something where they can learn a lot. They may also be able to deal with and meet with the different kinds of people, may be able to travel and also learn about other cultures, other people also. And many times they also have a very fun oriented relationship with their parents also, where they will joke with them, they will be witty, and they will also have fun with their teachers also, even tease and pull the legs of teachers also. There will always be one teacher who will be their favorite, and they will also be the favorite of their teachers. In the domestic, they will have a lot of Pisces energies of lot of giving and asking for less. So in their domestic life, they will always be looking at where can I do more, where can I contribute more, and expect less from their domestic life, both from their spouse as well as their children. And hence many times they end up at the receiving end also, especially if they don't get a good spouse or a good domestic life. And very late in life, they realize that they have got less out of it. And if they are a little emotional about it, especially with moon strong, then they also, there is a lot of internal complaint, internal sobbing. Yet whenever it's needed, they are the first people to stand by their family, stand by their spouse, and they try to protect their domestic life also, their household also. And they're very optimistic, and that's why they stay in the relationship, because they feel with time things will change, with time things will stabilize, and they continue in the relationship sometimes without any reciprocation, because they feel things will change with time. And the same thing they do also, how they approach challenges in life, obstructions in life, because they get overawed suddenly by challenges and issues also. However, because they're optimistic, they deal with challenges and issues in life with a lot of optimism also. They go out of their way to care for others who themselves are in challenges and issues, and they will not bat an eyelid to go out and help others who they feel need their help. And the same approach they also have towards expenses. And the expenses go through a huge roller coaster, right? Because of they being too optimistic, they spend a lot of money assuming or hoping that money will come in, only to realize there is a big dearth of money. And then suddenly they will pinch pennies for some time, save some money, suddenly only to be optimistic, thinking now that the money is coming, now that we have saved so much, let me spend some money and another more money will come in, only to realize that they are facing challenges continuously. So these guys need to definitely pull up their socks where expenses are concerned. In the relationships, they have a lot of Gemini energies, which means in their commitment, they take some time whether they need to commit to somebody, especially when they are fructifying the relationship into long-term committed relationships such as marriage. So they will have doubts whether they should get into a relationship or not, whether the person is right for them, whether the relationship will serve them or not. And this happens sometimes even after getting married to the person, for some time they will still have doubts. Anytime they have any challenge at home in their domestic life, again the same doubt comes to their mind. Am I in the right relationship? Will this relationship even survive or not? And the same thing they have also about in their social life. Many a times they hesitate to make friends. They are a little introvert in making friends. But if they make friends, then they will be the people who will also be the first people first on the scene to help others. For them, relationships are the key to having a social life. So they have a very balanced social life, and unless they are convinced, they will not have a relationship with, or they may not have social life outside. But if they make it, then they will be the people who have very, very strong relationship outside, though with few people. And the same approach they also have how they work or how they manifest their energies. In their hard work, they will work very hard, and then suddenly they'll think, is my effort really worth it? Am I getting the fruits of my labor or not? And should I continue in doing this or not? And when they put in the effort, they do it with a looking at the bigger picture, thinking that this will manifest in the future. But in their partnerships, in the project work, if they feel that the relations, the results are not coming in soon, then they also develop cold feet. They think twice whether they should continue to put in the effort or not. And in the manners of how they make money, what directs their careers, here a lot of analytical energy controls how they take decisions, which career to take up, which vocation to take up, which industry to work in. And once they take it up, they work with a lot of dedication to earn their money. They don't mind being patient, working very hard over a period of time before asking for growth. And they think that patience and perseverance and being very service oriented and deserving first before desiring is the key. And so for them, sometimes the growth is very slow at work. However, these people also have the same approach to overcoming competition and working with colleagues. They also are very analytical in how they deal with colleagues. But they also look at, if I'm supporting somebody at work, will this also help me in my career in the long run? And generally, when they take up any job or they serve in some industry, money is also an important criteria for them. And that is how results manifest for a Sagittarius ascendant native in the Navmansh. For Capricorn ascendant natives as the Lagna in the Navmansh chart, you will find that those people who are born in the Aries, Leo or Sagittarius signs in the Lagna chart may not be born with Capricorn as an ascendant in the Navmansh chart, which means that those people who have Capricorn in the Navmansh or the Lagna will have a lot of earth energies, air energies or even water energies as their main overarching energies, but less of fire energies, how they deal with situations and challenges and issues in life, unless they have a lot of planets in either Aries, Leo or Sagittarius signs in the Lagna chart. And what does this mean? The main signs which control the Kendras, the 1st, 4th, 7th and 10th house, are also the ones which control not only the 4 Kendras but the entire horoscope and the entire lives, which means that the energies of the Lagna of Capricorn energies also control the trine houses, which means how they deal with the matters of children, in their romance, in their investments, will also be with a lot of dedication and commitment and with a lot of patience and due diligence. So they will have a lot of patience with how they deal with children, how they work with children, how they allow children to take decisions, and they are also patient in having children. They will not hurry into having children the moment they get married. And the same thing in the romantic relationship also. They show a lot of patience in their romantic relationship also, and they are very committed. Seldom will you find a Capricorn person going out of the relationship and double dating people, because they feel it is important to be committed to one person in romantic relationship. However, in their investments, money is the one which makes the investments go. If they feel that they will not get good returns, high returns, even over a period of time, even when they are patient, then they may not invest in that venture. If they feel they will lose money, in spite of being patient over a period of time, they will not hesitate to pull out of the investments quickly. But if they feel they make less money, but they will make stable, consistent money over a period of time, they will go for that investments. Lot of Capricorn ascendant natives in the Navmansh may go for mutual funds or long-term investments. And same is the energy with which they also have, or they approach the higher studies. They take up degrees in higher studies or higher degrees or which university to go with a lot of thought through decision making, through a lot of logical decision making, and they are very committed to their learning. So they will spend long hours getting high qualifications, doing the PhDs, and they will look at their degrees very, very analytically. If they feel they don't have aptitude for a certain degree, for a certain education, then they may not take it up. But once they take up something, they'll put in a lot of effort to manifest that degree. They will also be seen as by their gurus or their father as being very, very committed and very, very diligent and very responsible. Now, in their domestic life, they have a lot of Aries energies, which means that in their household, they take a lot of interest, they take a lot of dynamic activity, they help in the household, they will take interest in how in repairs in the house, in matters of the house, in doing up the house, in buying things for the house. they will not leave it completely to the spouse. If spouse asks for help, they will be the first people who also come forward to help also. They may also not hesitate to take up some responsibility of the home if asked to, and they will do it with a lot of efficiency. However, many times if they feel that they are not being reciprocated, the effort is not being reciprocated, they may also lose interest in that particular activity very soon. So many times they may take up a responsibility only by after some time being told by the spouse that you said you will be doing it, you did it well for 2-3 months or few weeks, but now you are not doing it. Only to be given some other responsibility and then doing it very well, only to then find again being pulled up, not being able to sustain their energy. So this also happens. This also happens with them in their love life. If they feel that they are not being reciprocated, they are not getting the love and affection in their love life, in their domestic life, then they may also lose interest in the domestic life also. And that's how they also approach their challenges in life. They will rush into overcoming challenges and issues the moment something happens, and sometimes they take decisions very quickly only to realize that the decision they took in a hurry when in an emergency situation may not have been the best decision. However, they rush in because they feel very responsible, not only for challenges in their own lives but also others. Especially in the matters of family, even extended family, they will be the first person to rush and to help even extended family, as they feel it is the responsibility to help. So they are very, very active in helping others and also overcoming challenges of the others. They will be the first people who will be able to, who will be done with overcoming challenges, whereas somebody else may take more time than them. In the matters of relationships also, they have a lot of Cancer energies which guides them, which means they are very emotional about their spouse. They feel very emotional about their conjugal relationship. So they are very, very giving and they are very, very attached to their spouse. And many times because of this, they also end up on the receiving end if they are not reciprocated with the same love, understanding and empathy. And the same empathy they also extend in their social life. Many of their friends circle or their social circle will also be based on a shared understanding, a shared empathy. If they cannot relate to a friend, if they cannot relate to a social circle, if they don't get along with them, they don't get the right vibes, then they may pull back from them, though they may not tell them. They will keep the relationship intact, but they may not be able to get along with them like a house on fire. And same thing, they also put in a lot of effort in how they work. If they feel attached to a certain activity, attached to a social cause or attached to any cause, then they'll put in a lot of hard work. But for them, the emotional gratification is important when they work very, very hard, and they do it with a lot of optimism that this will bear good fruits for me in some time also. But if they find that their confidence is wavering or they are not emotionally attached to that anymore, then they may not be able to sustain that effort for a long period of time. How do they make their money? They make their money through relationship. Relationships is key for them. If they find they're getting a good deal in their work where they are working for a good brand, then they may even be ready to put in a lot of hard work. If they feel they're getting paid commensurate to the amount of effort they're putting in, commensurate to the growth that they should enjoy, then they may put in more effort than is needed also. And that is how they also look at earning money. But in earning money, many times they look at the big picture. How much overall money I'm getting, whether I'm working for a big brand or not. And many times they're not able to save enough. The small things they may overlook of the extra perks they are getting, and that's where they lose many times before signing on the dotted line. They earn big money and many times they do very well in their careers based on how well their relationship with the supervisors is. If they can have good relationship with the supervisors, with managers, then they also do very well. They also make good money and they also grow faster. And the same approach they also have with people or colleagues at work. They will have good relations with people at work, with colleagues at work, or at least they will try to have that. If they find that they have run into some challenges with a colleague, they may still not spoil the relationship with that person, but may take a back seat or may avoid that, but definitely not harbor any animosity. And that's how the results will manifest for a Capricorn ascendant native in the Navmanch. The Aquarius ascendant native in the Navmanch is a person who may not be a person who was born in the Aries, Leo or Sagittarius ascendant in the D1 chart. Which means if somebody is born in the Aries, Leo or Sagittarius Lagna in the D1 chart, then they may not be born with an Aquarius ascendant in the Navmanch. What does this mean? It means that the Aquarius ascendant native may carry a lot of earth energies, water energies and air energies rather than fire energies in how he or she deals with a lot of situations in their life. The overarching energies for an Aquarius ascendant native in the Navmanch are the four Kendra sign energies, which means the Aquarius, the Taurus, the Leo and the Scorpio energies are the main energies which control most of the areas of your life and in fact the entire life rather than the other sign energies, which means that the Lagna will also control with the same Aquarius energies the trine houses of the 5th and the 9th house as well. This means that the Aquarius energies are the ones how he will deal with the matters of children. In dealing with children, he or she will look at the bigger picture. If the children are working hard, they are putting in the effort, then even if the children are not getting the best of results, they will look at the big picture that at least my son or my child is studying, they are committing, they are putting in effort. If not today, then tomorrow they may get the success. So they deal with them with a lot of patience. Same thing, they may also look at the big picture in their romantic liaison. They tend to ignore small issues which may affect the relationship and they tend to look at the big picture. So the approach is, I love this girl or this boy and he or she cares for me. I don't really care about the small issues in life. We can always overcome those small challenges through understanding, through communication. And so these people deal with a lot of issues around children or in the romantic liaison through communication and sort issues through communication. However, in dealing with the investments, they may look at the big picture like, okay, this stock is very good. This is with a very prestigious company. So they may look at the big picture and invest money only to later on develop doubts about whether the investment will support them or the romantic liaison will help support them or serve them in the long run. And hence sometimes the doubt is what creates challenges and issues in the investments or in the romantic liaison also, or whether the children will do well in how they deal with children, or should they have a different approach to children, or should they crack the whip. And same way they approach their higher education also, where based sometimes on the relationship, which means if they find that a certain colleague in the school or their college is taking up a certain degree, then they may also take up the degree because they feel, oh, my friend is taking this, I think that this is a good one, I should also take this. So sometimes the relationships or their gurus or their father may goad them or counsel them or maybe convincing them to take a certain educational degree or certain educational qualification. There then they look at the big picture, the Aquarius energy kicks in that, okay, I don't really mind, this looks good, in the long run this will definitely support me, even if I'm not completely convinced with this, but because my dad has said or my colleagues have said this or my guru has said this, then maybe this will work for me in the long run. At home in the domestic life, they have a lot of Taurus energies, which means sometimes they may come across as at home as being a little stubborn, and their family may think that the person is a little stubborn and wants to push their agenda of how the home should function. And so many times they have to watch their guard because there may be also strong pushback from the domestic life, from their families. And that's how they also approach their expenses. In the expenses, though they are very diligent, they are very practical, they look at pennies also, but it is all about money, whether I'm saving enough or not. So many times the expenses are also around money rather than utility. So if they want to buy something of utility, they may look at money very, very closely before they end up buying that item. So saving money is important for them because they feel that financial security is important. And in the matters of how they deal with challenges and issues and obstructions in life, sudden events in life also, they sometimes do it very stubbornly, but with a lot of analytical approach. So if they're convinced after looking at data, after looking at various scenarios that a certain decision has to be taken, then they will not flinch from the decision. They will uphold that decision even at the cost of getting into bad books of others, where their family may feel that they are not listening to them in matters of emergency where they should listen to everybody else also, they should take counsel from others. But this person, because he or she is convinced how the matter that they deal with, their insurances, their financial, their wealth management, they're convinced based on their data, their analysis, they go with their decision. In the matters of relationships, a lot of Leo energies guides them, which means many times in the relationship, they may be those people who may come across to the partner as a little controlling and also maybe a little egoistic. And many times personality issues may create challenges in the marriage rather than anything else. Partner may feel that the person is trying to control him or her and wants to take the decision or wants to lead the household. And that's how they also come across many times to their extended social network, even to their friends. They try to be friends with people whom they can have fun with. So if they're not having fun with a certain group and they're not enjoying themselves, then they may take a back seat. And most of their friendships or their social group will be based on whether they like the company of those people or not. However, they also feel very responsible for their friends, and they will go out of the way to help those friends also, sometimes give them unsolicited advice, sometimes give unsolicited support to them also, and will take responsibility even not being asked to, or will ask whether I can take responsibility for you. And that's also the approach, how they approach hard work. They will be very, very hard working, and they'll put in lot of hard work and blood and sweat to be able to get certain output out of their projects, and they will take a lot of responsibility and accountability for the hard work, and they get excellent results over a period of time for their hard work. In the matters of how they make money, how they approach careers, sometimes they are not the ones with the best of luck, because their careers seem to be going up through ups and downs, and many times career may be going well for a few years only to stagnate, only to go downhill for another few years, only to look up again for a few years. So it's always a roller coaster ride at work, and that's how they also deal with money, with a lot of Scorpio energies, which means the money comes in, they have good savings, only suddenly sometimes to break the saving because expenses go through the roof, and most of the time the expenses are on family rather than on themselves. So because of some family base or home base event that comes in, they spend money, so they have to break the savings only to again start working on the savings alone. And so in their careers and in their savings, there is a lot of ups and downs. However, they are very optimistic about their spending also. They feel that more money will come in, so I don't mind spending because it is an important expense. So they're very optimistic about their money and about their financial situation, and hence many times they hesitate to ask for more money from their work. And the same approach they also take in dealing with colleagues at work. They also face obstruction, the challenges and more competition, even sometimes working behind the back, yet they will deal with colleagues with a lot of empathy, with a lot of understanding, though they keep facing challenges at work also, where others may not be as caring, as empathetic for the person. And that's how various situations will manifest for an Aquarius ascendant native in the Navmas. And last but not the least, for a Pisces ascendant native, as the ascendant in or the Lagna in the Navmas, you will find that these people are not the ones who are born in Aries or Leo or Sagittarius ascendants in the D1, which means a person who is born in either Aries, Leo or Sagittarius ascendant in the D1 will not have a Pisces Navmas as the Lagna. And the overarching energies for the Pisces person in the Navmas are the Pisces energies, the Gemini energies, the Virgo and the Sagittarius energies. And these not only control the Kendra houses in the Navmas chart, but the entire life and the entire horoscope. And what does this mean? It means that the Pisces ascendant native in the Navmas, most of his energies in life will be, most of the situations in life will be either by air energies, water energies or earth energies rather than the fire energies, at least from how his Lagna or his mindset approaches challenges and issues. And the trine houses are also controlled by the Kendra sign energies, which means the Pisces energies not only control how he thinks, how he acts in his life, but also how it manifests the fifth house of children, of romantic liaison, of investments, as well as his ninth house of higher learning, high degrees and dealing with gurus and father. So the person will be very optimistic about his children, optimistic about his investment, optimistic about his romantic relationship also, and many times in will show a lot of care to his children, will be very attached to his children, show a lot of empathy, and many times they justify the shortfalls of the children or the romantic person also because of having too much empathy, too much understanding for the person without looking at what the other person is doing. And they're too optimistic about the relationship also, as well as very having high empathy, and many times they get to know very late that they were wrong in how they were dealing with the children or in the romantic relationship, because it is not working out the way they want to, and maybe they're spoiling the children because of having too much understanding or too much empathy and justifying the actions. And they also care a lot about their romantic partnership, romantic liaison, and sometimes if they are not reciprocated or the relationship breaks, then they go through a lot of heartbreak. And the same approach they also have towards investments. Most of the decisions are also very emotional decisions for them. If they get a gut feeling that this, and they are very optimistic about an investment, they will go for it. Seldom will the decision will be based on pure data, which a Virgo ascendant person may do in the Navmanch. And so many times their investments also go through ups and downs because of being too optimistic in how they approach the investments. Same thing they also do, have an approach towards higher education with the Pisces energies, which means they are very optimistic about a certain degree, very optimistic about a certain institute, and they will take up that course only to realize that it is not serving them as it should serve because it has Scorpio energies as well. And later on they realize that this is not for me, and though sometimes they may also change course midway. They may take up an educational degree, they may finish that only to do PhD or the master's in something else. In their relationship, especially connected to their domestic life, they may be guided by the Gemini energies, which means in their home they will be very communicative, they will deal with situations with a lot of communication with their partners, with the family, and then the decision will be taken. However, sometimes even after a decision is taken, after communication, due agreement, yet sometimes they start having doubts whether I should have bought this furniture, whether we should have bought a house here, whether we should have invested here. And because of those doubts also, many times he or she changes decisions at home or related to home. And the same energies also guide them in dealing with emergencies or obstructions or challenges. When an obstruction or challenge or emergency situation comes in, they may take a decision only to then doubt whether I should have really taken this insurance, or whether I should have done this, or should have done something else, whether I should have gone to a different hospital. So they will always have doubts in their minds how they make investments, how they deal with taxation issues, how they deal with the government, how they deal with challenges and issues in life. And the same Gemini energies is also how they control their finances, the expenses, and how they deal with foreign lands or foreign companies. They will always have doubts about whether their expenses are being done right, but many times they end up doing expenses on the large ticket items, and they have doubts about the small ticket items, and so they don't spend money on the small things, but they spend large money on large items, only to then have doubts later on the large investments also. And so this is a work in progress for a Pisces ascendant native in the Navmanch chart. In the relationship, in the conjugal and the marital relationship, they are very analytical. So before they get into a relationship, they will think 10 times. They will look at various facets of life, facets of the individual, whether they get along well, whether they are the right partners for them, and only after looking at various facets of the person and being convinced, then they may get into the relationship with them. That's how they are at business also, or working with partners. And that's the same energy they bring even to how they deal with social life. Many of their friends will be those people which the person can get along with and has similar thought process, because the person is very analytical about his social company also, and analytical about his friends also. Many times he may come back home and talk to his spouse how his friend did this, his friend did that, and how it was wrong for his friend to say this or to do that. Sometimes even on the face of the friend, the person may not hesitate to tell him where he is going wrong and what he should be doing, but they are very committed to the relationship, they are very committed to their friends, they are very committed to their social circle, and they will be the first people to help them also when a situation arises. And the same thing with about hard work also. They will put in a lot of hard work, but they will do a lot of smart work also, and only when it serves them monetarily also. If something is not serving them monetarily, and if they don't see a good result for them in the long run, they may hesitate to put in. But if they find that their data, the analytical ability or the analysis says that it will serve them and it will also make the money for them, will serve them in the long run, then they may also indulge in that hard work, they may put in that effort. And lastly, how do they deal in their careers? How do they deal with money? In their careers, many times they are very adventurous, what roles they take up, what brands they are working at, what designation they agree for, and they usually have a lot of fun at work. If the work is not fun for them, they lose their interest easily, and so many times they also jump organizations because they don't feel completely at ease there. They are either not having fun or they are not making money also, because money is an important criteria, but also getting along with people at work, enjoying what they do is also important. And so many times the money decisions are also around fun, which means if they like to do what they are doing, if they like the company at work, they also make amends on the money part. They also make sacrifices how much money they are earning if they feel that they are more comfortable in their work arena. However, money is important for them and they work very, very hard for the money. Once they join a company, even when they are having fun, they will work very, very hard to earn more money. Their focus definitely is on money and to have financial security. And that's how they also deal with colleagues at work, or when they take up a certain service, they'll take up a project with a lot of responsibility and a lot of commitment, and also they take up responsibility even for the teamwork. So if the team worker asks them for help or support, they will take up that project, and they will also feel responsible for the team worker as well as for the project, and they will also take a leadership approach when asked to and when the situation demands. And that's how the Pisces ascendant native and the Navmansh manifest various results in their life. So friends, now that we have seen how the 12 ascendants in the Navmansh, these results will manifest for different ascendant natives, please look into what is the lagna of your Navmansh, what are the situations which are being thrown up, how various situations are manifesting, but also look at them in tandem with what the D1 chart is saying, because only when you bring them together do results manifest most for you, bringing in the best results for you. So friends, like this video, share this video, and if you're looking for a personal consultation for me, please reach out to me, the link is given below. Till some other time with some other video, this is your friend astrologer and guide Irfan signing off. Ciao.